today we're gonna do the CAF for flat sharing together.
Approximately 800,000 students receive personal housing assistance from the CAF each year. To apply for it, you just need to be French or have a valid resident permit. To have a decent home, more than 9 square meters for one person, to be unrelated to the owner, and to have resources below a certain ceiling, 12,000 euros per year for one person. Before applying, you can start by doing the simulation to know if you are entitled to it or how much you can receive from the CAF. To make your request, you will need to bring some documents, your lease, an ID or your passport, and finally, your bank account number. Also, know that with the CAF, it's mandatory to have a housing insurance. If you don't and the CAF control you, you can get a fine. In a share flat, all roommates must appear on the contract. Otherwise, it will not be valid for the CAF.
So, once you are on CAF.fr, you can go on Mes services en ligne, online services, and then you have the choice. You can either do a simulation where you can know if you are eligible to the CAF, and also you can know how much you will touch from the government. Otherwise, you can go and directly apply for the CAF. So it's what we're gonna do. Once you're here, you only need to click on Vous n'êtes pas locataire right here. Once again, they ask you if you want to do a simulation or apply directly. So we are gonna apply directly. So once you're here, you only need to click on create an account and start. So once you're here, you need to put some information about yourself. If you're like Madame, Monsieur, your last name, your first name, your birth date. If you're born in France or abroad. If you are living in France, so yes, and your postcode. And finally, the number right here. So I'm gonna do that and come back to you. So once you're here, you will need to put your phone number or your email address to have a validation code. I really, really, really advise you to put a French phone number. If you don't have one, you have the app which is called On Off that lets you have a French number at least for a time. And it's really important because otherwise you won't receive the code. Okay, so here you need to put the code you receive on your phone or per email. Now you need to invent your password. So it needs to be between 8 and 24 characters, one number, one small letter, and one big one. And finally, pay attention because they won't accept it if you have a special character. So this page is just a recap of what the information we just put, and you will need to click on se connecter.
So normally now you had received your temporary number, and you can just go on my account right here. Because you don't have your social security number yet, you just need to click on j'ai un identifiant provisoire. I have a temporary number. So now you just need to fill your temporary number. Once you're done, you just need to put your password and click on connect myself. Here you just need to go down and click here. I've taken in account the conditions and we continue. So once you're connected, you can go on online services right here, apply, do the application, start. So here you need to put your postcode. So are you in a couple or not? Just put that you are single if you are not married. Are you a student? Yes. Number of children? Just put 0 if you don't have any. Do you pay the rent or are you refunding a loan? So this one. This is the date of the starting date. Are you fiscally attached to your parents? Normally your parents are abroad, so you just can put no. And click here, This question is about, like, is your accommodation owned by your parents or a member of your family? Know that if it's yes, you won't be able to have any financial aid from the government. So for us, we're just gonna put no. And if renting contract at your name, your parents' name, or someone else, and let's continue. So this is just a small recap of what you just continue. So this should be attached to the information you brought the first time. So your name and everything. Just right here you can put other as your nationality. And here it's your father last name, father first name, mother last name, and mother first name. Do you live abroad? Yes. And this must be your date of arrival in France. Here it's your family situation. So single, divorced, and other things. You just put single. Are you waiting for a child to come? No. And continue. Here you need to put that your what kind of student you are. So just a student. This is also really important. It's student hospitalier. It's when you're a student but working in a hospital. So we're just gonna put students. Do you have a bursary? No. And continue. So once you're here, it's already fulfilled and you just need to put the name of the street and the number of the street. Now you need to put some features of your accommodation. So it's a studio, flat, or house, or is it just a room in a shared flat with or without toilets? You need to put the surface of accommodation. Is it does it have furniture or not? Are you in a flat share? No. The amount of the rent. Is the accommodation decent? Yes. And just continue. Here it is your landlord, private or in public. So if it's an agency, you just put here, or if it's just single man, you put here. Is your landlord in France or abroad? In France. This is the CERET number. You can find it on Google. You just need to put CERET and the name of the company. So we're gonna do that and continue. So this is just a small recap to be sure that it's your landlord company. So yes, and continue. So this question is about if you have a second accommodation because of an internship or information. Just know and continue. This is a recap of all the information you put since the first step, and you need to look if everything is on board and click on continue. So after clicking twice on continue, I'm at the step where I need to put my IBAN, so my bank account. Because if you don't have a French bank account for now, you can just continue later, so continue plus tard. Otherwise you can put it. It's better if you put it right now because it will be faster. So this is the end of the process. You just need to come back later when you will have your French bank account to finish it. So you will need to go on Mes services en ligne, faire une demande de prestation like last time, and then click on reprendre une demande en cours. So continue my application. Thank you for everything. It was Juliette from Live in France. If you have any other question, do not hesitate to contact me on hello@liveinfrance.com. It will be a pleasure to answer you. Thank you very much again. Bye bye.